My earliest puzzle memory is probably putting them together at Christmas with my mother.
She said to me that I would just sit there for hours and hours and just, you know, dump out the puzzle and put it back together, dump it out and put it back together.
I was 3 or 4. I was doing a 50 to 100 piece underwater themed puzzle. It was pretty difficult for me, but it was also pretty exhilarating.
I solve puzzles with my grandmother who has Alzheimer's disease. When we're solving the puzzles, we can actually talk about the thing.
It was somewhat early on in the relationship, but I think we were both slightly apprehensive about bringing it up. Once it was out in the open, it was like, all right, let's talk about it, let's do it. You know?
Puzzling brings me a lot of joy and happiness.
It's centering and it's grounding and it's relaxing.
People talk to each other about different kinds of things while they puzzle. It's rather intimate.
Puzzling is meditative, does that make sense?
Puzzling is therapeutic.
That's what I was looking for.
Once you get into a flow, you're not really thinking anymore.
It makes me want to solve problems with you and know that I can trust you to do that with me.
It's a time that I just have to myself.
You just think that every puzzler is going to be, you know, your 86-year-old Aunt Em, and that's not the case, because I'm a puzzler.
Puzzle people are complex.
Creative.
Amazing. Fun.
Sometimes a little kooky like me.
Putting in the last piece is,
yay!
Look what we did, look what came together.
It's bittersweet.
Because it means you're done. And then you have to go do real life.
Now I gotta let it go. Now I gotta let it go.
The best puzzle day is one at the beach.
A rainy or snowy Sunday.
A day where you have nothing to do.
The best puzzle day is every day.